jellied meat, madame?
I'm good.
If I may ask, Your Majesty, what exactly is the prince thinking?
Thinking about what?
It's no secret he has his doubts about assuming the throne. And if he doesn't, I'm afraid...
Prime Minister, let me put your fears to rest. Richard will accept his father's crown.
Your Majesty. You look absolutely radiant.
Thank you, Simon.
Prime Minister, tell me, where is my beloved cousin? Still gallivanting across the continent?
Greetings, Your Highness.
Good evening, Prince Richard.
Here he is.
Sorry, I'm late. I couldn't find my cufflinks. Majesty? Prime Minister?
Your Royal Highness.
Hello, cousin. I heard I just missed you in Mallorca. I was staying with the President. In his chalet.
Ah, well, I was on the beach in a tent.
Still soul-searching.
Oh, at least I've got one.
Ah. Excuse me.
Mrs. Averill, good to see you both.
Are you enjoying the party?
I am. Thank you for inviting me.
You seem rather fascinated with my brother.
I was just looking for something to eat. And I'm not a big fan of meat jelly.
Me neither. Follow me. Better?
So better.
I've been meaning to ask you. Why are you so nice to me all of a sudden?
Because you're different from everyone else here.
Because I don't know how to curtsy and I break everything.
Because you treat me like a normal child.
You are a normal child.
With a castle and a crown.
Nobody's perfect.
Princess Emily.
Cousin Simon. I didn't know you were coming.
I wouldn't miss your brother's coronation for the world. Did the Queen invite one of the chambermaids?
This is my tutor, Miss Martha Anderson, and I invited her. Miss Martha, meet Simon, my cousin.
Nice to meet you, Simon.
You shall address me as Lord Duxbury.
I find that nobility who insist on using their titles the same as those who drive Ferraris.
And what's wrong with my Ferrari?
Nothing wrong with it. It's just what it's compensating for that's the issue.
Hmm.
Lord Duxbury, how lovely to see you both at the same time.